Now I would request Dr. Murthy, the convener of WCPA from India, WCPA India, kindly come forward, sir, with your views.
Good evening, everyone. Dr. Martin, very much, thank you so much for your thought-provoking discussion. I think there are few people who may not be aware of what this Earth Constitution we are talking about, so I'll just quickly brief through.
Yeah.
UN was started in 1945, and even at the formation level, many global intellectuals realized that this structure based on charter would not help the world at all. And WCPA was formed in 1958. And it has been working on bringing in a global structure of global governance under Earth Constitution. Many people, many intellectuals from different parts of the world over long period, decades long, they have sat, discussed, deliberated, and given a shape of this Earth Constitution. That is the background to it. Now, in fact, the very interesting part, Dr. Glenn, perhaps you also would agree, is the UN Sustainable Goals are of latest origin. Earth Constitution, in as early as its formation, you know, it had this idea in its mind. If you look at Article 4, which Dr. Glenn Martin was saying, See, the vision is in Article 4. And the structure to implement it is in Article 7. You know, I always get very much interested in Article 7.3, mainly because that is the way we should have gone ahead. Now, the second point which I want to share is, as Dr. Glenn said, under UN Charter and UN Sustainable Goals, it is only a thought. I don't think there is any togetherness involved there, and there is no responsibility involved there. And Dr. Glenn, you know, I would like to bring it to the notice of our panel as well as the audience. In many parts of the world, a similar situation exists. Even in India, we have federal structure where there are states and there is a central government. Central government makes a budgetary allocation, and it is just giving away the money, doling out money, and the states are to, use it for the welfare of the people, and there is no account on it. And you know, you would be very much interested to know this. For all these years, right from 1947, 10% of this national budget went into a particular state. And today, even today, the state highway does not have a light. You know, I visit a place, I don't want to name it, but anyway, that is a fact. So what I am saying is togetherness and responsibility. You see, not only doling out the money, but for implementation, you know, it cannot just merely come out of a charter, certainly. Yeah. And there needs to be a governance system, global governance system. And then governance system should be binding on everybody under the sky. And we need this because, you know, no feudal or imperial system can grow on its own. You see, I just saw one question from Dr. Wasif. He said, why are we like this? You know what happened? UN says, here is the money. World Bank says, here is the money. And the money is spent, accounted in the balance sheet. And some people even cannot return it, or they cannot do the debt service, but the situation continues to be the same. Now, this has to change because there has to be a governance system. And very importantly, we have emphasized again here today, the emphasis on GDP. Being a commerce person, you know, being an accountant, I can say GDP is a very flawed measure. Because GDP is based on money count. The very definition of money says money is what money does. So money goes on multiplying by itself, and it doesn't care about the implication. Money grows, but does the social welfare grow? Does the benefits grow? Does it make people more comfortable, happy, and satisfied? That never, money never looks at it. So similarly, this idea of GDP-oriented growth is a flaw. In fact, let me say this. In our own case, at one point when the country was growing at 8.2% GDP, which was the highest, we had the highest unemployment situation. It is a paradox. You know, many people who knows economics, they can say if we were growing at 8.2%, we must have had nil unemployment situation. But we had the highest unemployment situation at that stage. So all this is just gimmicks and maneuvered and manufactured figures. We need to get on with the proper approach. We need a different measure altogether. Finally, to address this, we need a binding governing system. What I am very happy is I wish to thank Dr. Hemlata Talesra and the team for taking up this the topic, which brings out the importance of Earth Constitution here. Like a way a soldier can fight, you know, only a soldier can fight, and awareness can be created by only the teacher. You see, I'm very glad that today the teaching fraternity has taken up this initiative of spreading the knowledge. You know, I think we can make this world a better place to live in. And I consider this conference is just the beginning of the change. You know, Gandhiji once said, be the change you want to see in the world. I think the organizers of this program have started it in good earnest, and I congratulate them. And with that, I thank you for giving me this opportunity to say my words. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Murthy. And from your expertise, you have elaborated upon things so well. And definitely after this, today's expert lecture, we'll have deliberations. And since we all are united and in a network through Hemlata Talesra ma'am, this is the brainchild of Hemlata Talesra ma'am coming upon this topic. So definitely we'll have more discussions and coming up with good recommendations as to the application part of the things that Glenn T. Martin has elaborated upon so well.